Feeling like I should issue a challenge to us in Kings. Elijah brings a boy back to life. Well, God brings a boy back to life through Elijah. And he carries him to the upper room first. And we like to use that verbiage like I'm going into the upper room, right? We like to pretend that we've been there. But if you had been there, when you touched somebody, they would come back to life. If you'd really been there, we need to stop fooling ourselves. Because if you had been there, your shadow, when you walked by, would heal someone. Like Peter's did. So we're posturing ourselves from a position of we've already been face to face with God. There's no upper level to go, and you haven't even entered the house yet. Posture yourself from the position of I haven't even been in the outer court yet, because there's always a new level, a deeper position to go, because the angels reveal and see something new every time they circle his throne. So if you think you've already been to the upper room, you may have once. What about on the next circuit? What about on the next circuit? What about on the next circuit? So my challenge to you is, this woman says in Kings, she says, now I know that you really are a man of God. And it wasn't because Elijah said he went to the upper room. It was because he performed a miracle from that place. Not going to perform a miracle unless you've been there.